First of all, I want to say what a pleasure it is to have Miss Janine Streeter with us here today. How are you doing, Janine?
Oh, super. How are you, Josh?
Very good. You are the Bloomingdale Elementary music teacher.
And correct.
You've been with them for how long?
For about 5 years, actually.
It's been about 5 years.
Oh boy, I'm getting old.
Well, I definitely want to talk about your work there because we actually have an exciting announcement to make in conjunction with what we're doing today. But I thought maybe if we could get a little sense of your musical background and sort of maybe start early on and maybe bring us up to how you sort of ended up where you did.
Oh, sure thing, Josh. I come from a very musical family, which I've been very blessed to have. And since I was little, I spent many a weekends watching my father play in a band. He is actually a member of our Streeter family band, the Adirondack Playboys. And they perform all over upstate New York, country music, old time country, bluegrass. And since I was, before I could talk, I remembered listening to him and his band play and him having a blast entertaining crowds. And that's what I wanted to do when I grew up.
And so you knew from early on?
Yes. Actually, Josh, when I was younger, I decided to play the violin because I wanted to be a part of that band. Didn't quite happen, but I went on to music school and pursued music.
Oh, that's great.
Good degree. Yeah.
That's great. So your father and his father before him probably bounced you on their knee. It's just sort of ingrained.
Right. In every family function, every holiday, there's always guitars and there's always singing and music. And everybody in my family's talented.
Oh, that's
musically.
Cool. Yeah, that's great. Yeah. So, I mean, what a foundation that was.
Yeah, it's a good time.
So moving forward, you ended up going through school and sort of playing your instrument, watching your family play, mm-hmm. and then it came time to actually get the education.
Yes.
And where did you do that?
Well, I decided I would like to pursue music, so I talked to my parents about that, and they wanted me full force. I signed up, went on to Ithaca College, mm-hmm. and Josh, I failed miserably. See, it's a top third college in the country. So I never took private lessons. I played violin, taught a lot of it on my own. Mm-hmm. Didn't have much music theory background, nothing. And when I got to college, I realized that I had years of catching up to do. There were kids that had private lessons since they were 5 years old, right. And that was not my situation. So I worked my tail off, and then I eventually transferred to the Crane School of Music in Potsdam, where I finally earned my Bachelor of Music Education degree.
So yeah. The thing of it is there's a lot more to music than just,
yes.
I know what you mean. A lot of people just pick up the guitar and learn a few chords. There's much more to it.
Yes, it's the theory and the history and the technique, and
right.
But I enjoy it.
Yeah, that's great. So after graduation, it came time to enter the real world find a job and that kind of thing. You were able to get into the school district and immediately?
Josh, I started out. I actually created a string orchestra program, an instrumental music program in Brewster, New York. And that's where I had my first teaching gig. About 6 years I spent at Brewster developing a program.
So
I had a great outing there.
You began
learned
to
a lot.
See the fruits of all your work from
yes.
school and whatnot.
And Saranac Lake, I've always passed through this town and just fell in love with it. It's so quaint, so perfect. The people are so friendly, and I was very fortunate to get a job here.
Sally, won't you teach me